Hello, 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 and welcome to this month's amazing lineup on the Her Version Impact panel. I have the most amazing female voices here sharing their expertise on the subject of entrepreneurship this morning on a Saturday. Join us as we discuss everything about building a business while still maintaining our sanity. Let's jump right in. Hello, hello, hello. My name is Sabrina Victoria. For those of you that don't know me, for those of you that are new to this podcast, make sure you follow, like, subscribe, and share. This podcast is dedicated to sharing stories of struggle to triumph and a platform that allows individuals to tell their truth in order to inspire and uplift others. Listen. Being a woman in today's world can have its ups and its downs. Being a woman building a business can have even more. I have put together a phenomenal panel of women who are here to give all their juicy secrets, hacks, be vulnerable in talking about the struggles they have endured through the process of building their businesses. For those of you that are listening live, we appreciate you being here and supporting us. This is an interactive forum, so feel free to comment or ask questions, and our ladies will be more than happy to give their advice. All you have to do is comment in the comment section. So welcome, ladies. How is everyone doing today?
Good morning.
Good morning.
I love that you guys are up and you are hanging out with me this morning on a Saturday. And this is one of the main things when it comes to building a business and being an entrepreneurship is we work sometimes. We work sometimes on Saturday morning. So thank you for being here with me and spreading the goodness of what all of this is. So the way that I handle this is I actually will hand the floor off to one of our beautiful entrepreneurs for 10 minutes. For those 10 minutes, that individual will be in charge of the entire floor, will be asking questions and answering questions. So the first person that I'm going to be handing the mic off to this morning is going to be Michelle. Michelle, can you hear me?
I can.
Awesome, Michelle. So I will be handing the floor off to you. Go ahead and give yourself a little intro. Tell us, you know, your name, where you're from, what you do, and then ask your question. And then we'll be here to answer it for you.
Thank you so much, Sabrina. I'm so excited to be here. I am Michelle Lee. I live near Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, in a very small town called Harmony. And I am a sales and relationship coach, and I work with a methodology to save people time, energy, and money and build really strong, authentic relationships with everyone in their life, helping them increase their sales, close deals faster, and really connect with people. The key to your business, the key to life, is connecting and understanding people. That's what's important. It's not about us. It's about the others and how we can help and serve them. So some of the questions that I get are, why is sales so difficult? And can I be good at it? Some people can sell anything and I don't want to sell anything, right? And the truth is that anyone can be good at sales. People have to understand that people speak different languages. And in order to connect to people, they need to know their audience, know what language they're speaking, whether that's their child, their prospect, their customer, their family. They need to understand that people show up differently. And they need to pay attention and listen. And then, like I said, speak their language. That's the biggest struggle, is that people go into it assuming that everyone is just like them and they need the same information. So when they go out there, they're actually turning off 75% of the people and not connecting to them because they aren't wired the same. So how many of you have gone and had a sale that was so easy? It was like, oh my gosh, I hit the easy button. Why can't they all be that way? They matched your personality. And that's why you connected. So some of the other questions that I get is, I don't like to sell. How can I get comfortable with selling? Well, everybody's selling every day. You're selling yourself. You're selling yourself on what you want to eat today, where you want to go. You're selling your children on why they should eat a piece of broccoli over that cookie. So once you get comfortable with the fact that, oh my gosh, like I'm literally selling every single day, it takes that edge off because you're just having a conversation. You're influencing, not manipulating. There's a huge difference. And when you understand the different languages that people speak, it makes you a stronger influencer. It makes you a stronger connector. It increases your emotional intelligence. Why do some people need to drive 20 miles out of the way to buy gas and save 3 cents while somebody else doesn't care what it costs? They just want to get the gas and go, right? So there's different ways that people are wired. And so I work with people on showing them those personalities, understanding how to communicate with each of them. And whether you're negotiating, whether you're selling, any conversation you have, you need to know who's in front of you. I lost everything I had in 2015. I had two small kids. I had no money. We literally got rid of everything in our house and I had to rebuild. And this was time and time again, right? We all have stuff thrown at us and we have to try to figure it out and move forward. But it's not how many times you fail. It's how many times you get back up and you keep fighting. Because everything that comes at you is pushing you into the life that you need and the direction you need to go. So when everything fell apart, I started a company with credit cards, right? Because the people I worked with needed a job and they had nowhere to go. If it weren't for them, probably wouldn't have went that route. But it pushed me into doing that. And so then I needed to figure it out because I was doing all of the things while raising two small kids, trying to pay my bills. I couldn't get paid from the company because there wasn't any money to do that. I had to worry about everybody else. But you can do it. Everything will line up. Everything will fall into place. You just have to be consistent and keep getting out there. Keep showing up. Does anybody have any questions or comments or anything? I don't want to keep talking to you.
Michelle, I have a question. What I've discovered lately in the past 10 years, I guess, is that when I go to, say, a cell phone store or almost anywhere where they sell, it sounds so canned and it sounds so unauthentic. They seem to have a script in their head. And I just come away with the feeling like they're little automatons. Like I've just been sold by a Stepford wife or something.
Right. So, and what's your question?
My question is, where does that come from and how can people avoid being perceived that way?
So, unfortunately, they do make scripts, right? But you want to be your authentic self. If you know who your audience is, and people are going to take it different ways. Another personality might not think anything of that, right? But I'm going to guess that you're a very high nurturing person. And so you want that connection. So if you look at the four personality types, right? There's a blueprint who's inside the box. They need structure, stability, systems, planning. They hate risk. There's an action person who's outside the box. They want opportunities and freedom. They're your movers, your shakers, your millionaire makers. They blew up the box. You have a nurturing person, right? Full of love. That's my heart. They want that connection. They want to build that relationship. They want to, and they're looking at people and saying, this person is not authentic at all. I don't want to buy from them because they don't even care about me. They just care about this sale. And then you have a knowledge person who's like, listen, without me, you wouldn't even have a box. I engineered the box. And they're the ones who are going to ask a ton of questions. They want all the science. They want all the research. They want all the data. It's got to be logical. It's got to make sense. And they're like, you know what? Give me the information. I'm going to research it. I'm going to analyze everything. I'll be back to you in a couple of months when I get the answer that I want, right? Because they don't want to be wrong. So when you look at that, other people would go into that store and they wouldn't, they'd be like, oh, okay. That's just normal. Just give me whatever. But you want to build that relationship. So that's why you have to be able to authentically speak the language of the different people around you, or you're going to turn them off, just like you were turned off by that. Does that answer your question?
Yes, it does. Thank you.
And I want to say good morning to everyone. And Cheryl just asked a question. Like, I find that when I focus on the person instead of my goals, it's more of a conversation. Good salespeople are good because they are seeking the need to fill. They have scripts because they're hiring people who don't know or care how to do that. It is a skill that must be practiced. That is a great comment there. And the thing is they're trying to help these people to sell. And so they're scripting it out, just like Cheryl said, so because they don't know what they're doing, right? And they're like, okay, well, if you give them a script, they're going to hit it. If you're talking to people and you don't know who they are and you don't have an idea of what their values are, then you need to touch on all four of those values so that you can communicate with them and see, okay, where's this person at? I need to meet them where they are. If you went to a foreign country, you wouldn't expect everybody to speak your language. You would learn the language of the people. And that's exactly what you need to do when you're having these conversations with people, is really you need to know who they are and what's important to them.
All right. That was absolutely phenomenal. Thank you so much, Michelle, for giving us that awesome information. We'd love to hear more about all the goodness that you have from the business that you're in as we kind of go along. So feel free to chime in as we go along.